Sure.
Yeah, once we
I'm
get...
just going to start talking. I'll tell the story.
Yeah.
And then...
yeah.
Wait for you.
Once that you know
like...
what's happening. Because
okay.
Nobody put their hands on you.
Shelby, it's them kids.
Yeah,
okay, that's fine.
I should get a pair of gloves.
Yeah,
you
can
just
get
somebody.
Hey,
Jamie.
Hey.
What you thinking, Jamie? Where's the rest?
All right, everybody.
No,
I
think
I don't think it was
0
that
one.
Yeah,
that one. That one. It was close. She was 8.5 cakes.
Hi, Facebook. We are here live at an animal hospital. Today, we're working with the Big Cat Rescue. And as you can see, we have a little baby bobcat kitten that is in our care today. He was found in the middle of the street. And Big Cat saw what was going on and they intervened. And they've had her since 6 o'clock this morning and they observed in one of their areas that she definitely had some sort of limp. So that's why she's here today at our animal hospital. And Dr. Boorstein,
can you put her in extra?
Yeah.
Is checking her out to see what the problem could be. So he's just doing a general examination right now. So
a girl.
Oh. Definitely a girl.
Definitely has a broken leg.
Definitely
a broken leg, he says.
Can I see her in the mouth a little bit? I just want, we're trying to age her. I think she's probably close to it.
So we're looking at her teeth to see how old she is.
All baby teeth.
Yeah.
All baby teeth. How old do we think she is, guys?
About 6 weeks
about
with
six
the
weeks.
Weight. Yeah.
So she's just a little itty bitty baby.
Now we just need to see how bad the fracture is. It feels pretty bad.
So Dr. Boorstein is saying there's definitely a fracture, and it does seem pretty bad. Area, and when she does get fixed up, they will rehabilitate her there, and then keep her at their facility, and possibly pair her with another bobcat, so she'll have a little friend. So what are we doing right now? If you're just joining, this is a little baby bobcat around 6 weeks old that was found in the middle of the road in Ocala and brought to our friends at Big Cat Rescue.
I'm glad we brought her straight here so we didn't like waste an exam.
Yeah. Totally.
One of our vets at our animal hospital.
That's what I was worried about.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Big Cat Rescue's teeth. So, he's checking her out. Definitely has a broken leg.
We can
fix her up and then return grab her and then get her brother home.
Oh, baby.
Skinny.
Very skinny. Thank you all so much for the donations, everybody.
Boorstein took a look at her, so they're just prepping her for her x-rays now. We know that there's definitely a fracture. She can tell just by looking at her and giving her a general exam and feeling her out.
Everybody, I was not doing a lot of commentary because we are at the Humane Society of Tampa Bay. They do have their own film crew here, and I'm sure you got the gist of that, but our baby bobcat from this morning, Angel, is going to be going into x-ray.
Okay. So we're going to have a brief pause while they do the x-rays. Hi, Dr. Boorstein.
Yeah, so they'll do the x-rays. Unfortunately, there's radiation in there, so you need badges and everything to be monitored. So.
No worries. How long have you been working on big cats?
I've been a big cat for over 15 years now, and I've been a vet there for 8.
Wow. So. What inspired you to start working with big cats?
I just always enjoyed exotic animals, and you know, unfortunately, I think I got into it for the wrong reasons.
Yeah.
You know, I thought they were cool as pets and stuff like that, and I learned very quickly that
yeah, definitely not pets.
These are not pets. They don't belong in homes, and they belong in the wild. So
yes.
This kind of work is my favorite kind of work, I'm sure, with everyone else at the sanctuary. Mm-hmm. You know, of course, it's great to take care of tigers and lions, but it's way better to take an animal that could be in captivity in certain hands, and now gets to go back to the wild.
Yeah. So let's see what we've got here, guys.
The tube's a little torn. So what I do, then pull it out a little bit. It does look repairable, but we'll shoot laterals and APs. Basically, we get two views of it, make sure there's no other fractures anywhere else in any of the other long bones in the pelvis. They just want to make sure there's no trauma to the chest, because we get to worry about things like pneumothorax or diaphragmatic hernias, especially if the cat got hit by a car. And so, in this case, I didn't see anything obvious. Just a giant stomach full of food, which is really scary during anesthesia.
She likes mud.
Yeah.
She does.
But
she's growing.
Yeah. But it is a kitten, so we also want them to kind of eat surrounding anesthesia.
Of course.
So probably end up getting a bone plate.
Bone plate, okay.
Like 9 a.m. So at least a while ago.
Like, yeah. We definitely can help and fix her up and,
yep. And get her back in the wild.
Get her back into the wild.
Yeah.
And that's what we're all about.
Another bionic bobcat for Florida.
Yes.
We've released a lot of them with metal in them.
Did we name her yet?
Angel.
Her name is Angel.
Angel.
Aww, that's
nice.
Sweet. That's
very
cute.
Angel
and
Robocat.
Yeah. All right, so. Surgery today, you said, most likely? Okay.
So you think, like, whatever repair you do
fixes
it, or do you have to, as she grows, keep doing
no,
something?
No, it should be one and done.
Okay.
And no, well, we'll wait to see the rest of the x-rays, but no obvious involvement in the joint, so as long as it heals well and there's no secondary problems like infection or plate failure, things like that.
She won't have to have a follow-up. She'll be good for the rest of her life.
She should be good for the rest of her life. Yeah, we'll recheck x-rays at, like, usually 6 to 8 weeks. And make sure they're healed, and then once they're completely healed, they come off all restrictions of big cat, and then they're just rehab like a normal bobcat. Mm-hmm. So.
Do you think you can tell from her break what caused it? Like if somebody grabbed her?
It could have been. I mean, there's no other trauma to it.
Yeah, it is so like road rash or anything. Really
normally, if you get hit by a car, you get
something on the body.
There was, I shouldn't say that, there was, it looks like a broken tooth. Possibly upper tooth, but it could be a deciduous tooth, baby tooth that fell out.
It would just be really incredible for a cat that size to get hit by a car and not die.
Right.
Yeah, she's so little. How much did she weigh?
On that scale? 1.5 pounds.
About 1.5 pounds.
Oh, she's only 1.5 pounds.
Yeah. So very tiny.
You get hit by a car and not have any additional damage. It's just a broken leg and the deciduous tooth you mentioned.
Yeah.
Well, that's
kind
of surprising.
It is.
Yeah.
They usually break their jaw. They have other lacerations.
They get road rash.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we get a lot of them, and the broken pelvis is quite often kind of multiple broken bones.
He didn't see any, two to four bite wounds or anything.
Yeah.
It's quite a mystery.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And it looks, it feels really fresh, like it's not very swollen or anything.
It's crazy that she's running around for hours this morning playing.
You admit she was climbing around in the cage and everything like that?
One-legged.
Yeah. Yeah, she just, everything she did, she just kept that leg up.
Yeah,
she's a tough
cookie.
Mm-hmm.
That's the scary part about wild bobcats, is that when you fix them, they tend not to care after you repair them, so they don't go easy.
Yeah,
on your
it's just full force.
It's full force.
They feel 100% better, so they're acting 100%.
Yeah.
So, that's going to be fun. I'm going to get, I think, a tiny, tiny plate.
How does that work with the plate sizes? Like, do you almost have to make it custom for her, or we have...
We stock all different size plates, but luckily when they get to the really small size, they make these... The ones that I buy are like cuttable plates, so I can just change the length.
Nice.
And so, and then I just stock all the size
screws.
Thank you,
I appreciate it.
But the screws are going to probably be pretty big, even the smallest ones I got.
Hmm.
And this is a question I think might have already been asked too as well, but with the animal's growth, what about the expansion of this broken leg?
As long as it is in the middle of the leg, it's not a big deal. Because the growth plates are at the end, they grow from the end.
That makes sense.
Let's see what we've got.
Yeah.
So this is her good leg, right?
It's her good leg.
Yes, that's the way it's supposed to look. And that's the way her bad one looks. So yeah, there's a clear difference there.
Get good at walking backwards. Oh, poor pup. All of our big cat people are a little confused by the dog noise when they join in. They're like, oh, what's happening?
What?
No, all of our people are a little confused hearing the dog. They're like, where are we? Okay, well, thank you guys so much, everybody who donated. I don't know that I... Will I be filming the surgery?
Yeah. We'll
okay. All right, so we will go ahead and shut this down. We're going to get a sweet little angel prepped for surgery. Get you a good view here. Definitely a broken leg. So, but he does think it's fixable. So we're here at the Tampa Bay Humane Society and we're going to get her all taken care of. Thank you so much for all the donations. You guys are why we're able to do this kind of medical care. 100% of your donations goes to the care of the cats. So I will most likely be coming back to you guys here shortly with another live. So thank you guys so much. See you guys soon.